Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we'll be seeing the WCDMA power control. As we know, CDMA needs power control because of the near-far problem. Hence, WCDMA being the advanced version of the CDMA, power control is also required over here. Power control is an essential part of the CDMA system as it is very necessary to control the mutual interference. Mutual interference means that the mobile phone that is transmitting higher power should not overlap the mobile phone that are transmitting with lower power. Hence, power control is important in both uplink and the downlink of the mobile phone system. Let us see first the uplink power control system. Uplink uses closed loop power control system. Closed loops means the signal that is transmitted from the mobile station to the base station, and the base station does the necessary changes to control the power level of the mobile phone. That is called as a closed loop system. The base station basically estimates the power of the received signal and controls by transmitting the TPC. TPC stands for transmit power control bits. The TPC is nothing but the instruction bits that has been sent to the mobile station, which changes its power accordingly. Now remember, the TPC, that is the transmit power control bits, are transmitted with a DPCCH, that is the dedicated physical control channel. It basically contains the instruction to either increase the power or decrease the power, and the possible step size is 1 or 2 dB in which power increases or decreases. This depends on the need of the mobile station. For soft handoff, the situation is very complicated as the mobile station is starting to receive the bits from different base stations that are involved nearby. And hence, there is a combined instruction which is formed, which is a function of the weighted single power control command. And this weighting is applied proportional to the reliability of the individual signal. Weighting means, depending on which base station is more appropriate for the mobile station, accordingly the power weights has been applied. In UMTS standard, there is a specific algorithm that is designed which will determine the mean of all the power control from the different power controls of the base station. Depending on the mean, the power level will be either increased or decreased. It is not possible to use a closed loop power control system on a PRACH, which stands for Physical Random Access Channel, as the dedicated channel has not yet established between the mobile station and the base station. Therefore, here open loop power control has been employed. The mobile station measures the average received power of the CCPCH, that is a common control physical channel, over some time to average out the small scale fading effect. This is done because due to frequency duplex, small scale fading on the uplink is unrelated to the fading of the downlink. In other words, it is not possible to determine from the instantaneous power on the downlink the actual level of the instantaneous received power on the uplink. The average received power allows the estimation of just the necessary power that is required for the uplink. Hence, the mobile phone measures the power received in the CCPCH over some time to average out the small scale fading effect. Let us see the downlink power control system. In downlink power control, all the signals on the downlink, that is towards the mobile station, suffer the same attenuation. Further, the downlink signals are orthogonal due to the use of codes that have been used for channelization, that is the PN code sequences, so that the despreading operation results in good signal to interference ratio. Therefore, the power control on the downlink is aimed mainly on maintaining a good signal to noise interference ratio. A closed loop power control system is used for downlink operation. Each mobile station measures the signal strength and the quality, and it transmits the TPC command over the base station via DPCCH, which stands for Dedicated Physical Control Channel. as long as at least one mobile station is starting to request for more power from the base station increases the power of all the channels, meaning there has to be at least one mobile phone which says the power from the base station is not sufficient enough, and hence the base station increases the power for all the channels in all the mobile phones. Therefore, the mobile station near the cell border are actually controlling the transmission power of the base station. The reason being, mostly the base stations are held at the center of the cell, and the mobile station having the weakest power is towards the edge of the cell or the cell border. Hence, that is the mobile phone which will control the actual power level of the base stations. So this is how power control in WCDMA takes place. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKida and subscribe to eKida.